Number 11, Kalichi Ike, original starter. Four-timer back in the game. Tourney with the steal and basket. Timeout.
Back at Wagstaff Stadium, we apologize for the delay, but obviously connection situations as we have a separate stream going on at the exact same time tonight, or this afternoon, with the TJC baseball program. So it has been a booger to keep connected and make everything work in sync here from Wagstaff tonight during the NJCAA Regional Championships. Kenny Smith back with game two. We apologize, we missed all of our pregame, but it's tied up at eight. TJC and Blinn, as the number four and five seeds squaring off here, and a couple of teams that are very familiar with each other over the years. Blinn coming in at number four and TJC coming in at number five. And for the second time in his many days, TJC on the visiting bench right now. But Tyler Junior College Apache Ladies. Blinn coming in at 21-5, 11-5 in conference play. TJC women at 18-12 and 9-7, fourth-seeded Buccaneers began their season winning eight of their first 10 games, finishing the regular season winning four out of five that included wins over six-seeded Panola and top-seed Angelina as well. And right now we are tied up. TJC bringing it down court. They're wearing black tops and bottoms. That is Blinn wearing their light gray tops and bottoms. And an inside or outside pass. Tried to go inside, and the ball went outside the court. So the dump-off inside to Isabello will go errant by DK, and DK out of bounds as Blinn now coming back the other side of the court, and here we go. Inside and outside. Boy, these extensions on these girls drive broadcasters crazy trying to read numbers on the back. So my apologies once again as trying to keep up with teams obviously from way atop Wagstaff.
Jackson comes back in for the
Apache
Ladies.
So Lillian Jackson back on the floor for TJC and the Apaches as they started with Kiana Bennett, Fontacone. Also, Kalichi DK.
Kalichi DK with the whistle, her first. Tyler, team foul number four. Winter Jones at the line shooting two shots.
Blinn right now, 2-point advantage over TJC. Back out top of the key as they'll continue to rotate to the right side to Bennett. Bennett looking inside. She gets it into Isabello. And she'll throw it the opposite side of the court. Kone looked open for a brief moment, but it'll be slapped out of bounds off of Winter Jones. Jones knocking it out for Blinn. And the Buccaneers will just force a new possession here for TJC. They can go get the shot clock, of course. Just ran out of bounds. TJC's got to get one off. Two on the shot clock. Shot off the inside glass. No good. Wrestling for it and fighting for it. Isabello continues. Get it under the basket. Ball gets loose and Blinn ends up with it. And now maybe getting away with a walk and a little bit of collision as they're going to get a lot of contact underneath and I think taking a shot to the face. For Blinn is going to be Takara Johnson. Johnson, a 5'11 freshman out of Crockett.
All five of them for the Lady Bucks.
And she'll come back, check out of the ball game. She may have taken a shot to the face. Checking back in is Richardson. As Nyla Richardson on the court now for Blinn. We're trying to set the court as quick as we can. Pull-up jump shot up the inside of the rim, no good. Aaron shot going in by Lillian Jackson. And once again, a lot of physicality right now and collisions all over the court. That time from Richardson. And Isabello going to get a foul called.
Lillian Jackson draws the whistle for her first. Patchy Lady team foul, number five.
It'll be Jackson with the first foul call.
Richardson.
Fifth team foul against TJC early in this one. We're at the 3:04 mark in the first quarter. It's a 10-8 lead for Blinn. And missing the front end of the free throw is going to be Richardson, averaging 5.5 points a night. She's a 66% free throw shooter. And set up now for her second as Blinn holds a 2-point lead. And shot is off the inside of the iron, no good. Long rebound inside the circle, right at the free throw line, actually. Giving up to Bennett. Bennett will penetrate inside the circle, backs it back out, setting the TJC offense. Inside the paint, Isabello. Now backs it back out, free throw line extended, hands off, left side to Kone. Kone down to the corner, thought about it, back to Kone. Kone's already used her dribble with the basketball hitting the floor, and now she'll put it down, but no double dribble call. Kone inside the circle, they got to put up a shot, three on the shot clock. Long two-pointer is short, no good, tipped around. And wrestled back around, the Blinn Buccaneers come up with it as Neal comes out of the scrum with it. As Janisha Neal, 5'4", freshman out of Houston, and she'll draw the foul on the drive to the right side. And foul's going to be called on Bennett.
Kiana Bennett, her second personal.
5'8", sophomore out of Shelbyville. Kiana Bennett, Fonte Kone, a 5'7", sophomore from Mali, Africa. And Kalichi DK, 5'10 freshman out of Sherland. Free throws again for Blinn as heading to the free throw line this time will be Janisha Neal. And shots up and good. Neal will move it to a 3-point advantage for the Buccaneers, 11-8. TJC, one of the only team in Region 14 to take down Blinn on both accounts this season. The only team to sweep Blinn Buccaneers, and Gina Tillis Horde wants a 30-second real quick. TJC, the host team, of course, and comes in as a fifth seed. Well, they've continued to battle injury and sickness train all season long with the majority of their year spent at less than 100% healthy for any length of the games. This is for the second straight year. This may be the healthiest they have been all season. The Apache women have a leg up of sorts coming into this opening round matchup against Blinn, as they've done this twice already this season, a 72-68 win on January 17th and an 80-70 win on February 17th. USA Basketball announced last month also that Trina Tillis Horde will be a part of their women's junior national team. So a great honor, as Trina talked about that during a game broadcast a couple of weeks back. So bringing it back across half court, TJC down by four after a couple of free throws are dropped by Neal. Driving the baseline, back outside there fighting. 4-5 seed, working her way hard to the hole and drawing the foul. Foul's going to be called on Jasmine Jackson. And taking it right to her is Isabello. Jackson's first personal foul. And we got tipped off on time, actually a little bit late time-wise on our schedule, but not too late. But our broadcast started a little bit late because of obvious video streaming delays. Well, rebound came down into the hands of Jasmine Jackson. And Jackson will pick up her second personal foul, and TJC again has been in the bonus for a little while, so every foul will bring out free throws for Blinn. The Buccaneers go back with a 4-point lead, 12-8 right now. So Jackson will sit down.
Jasmine Jackson.
And DK will check back in the ball game. DK, a 5'10 freshman out of Sugarland. And Blinn continues to hurt the Apache women from the free throw line, as she will knock that one down. J. Jasmine Jackson averaging 5 points a night. 46% free throw shooter. 1 for 2 this particular round. And a rebound coming down to Isabello. TJC across half court. Kamara Jackson will start the offense up for the Apache women. Inside two-step. Shot is up. No good by DK. Rebound comes down by TJC, and Apaches will finally get the putback, and a strong putback by Isabello. Isabello now with 4 points, but quickly, Blinn will get it down court with two passes and a quick basket by Singleton. Chesley Singleton, a 5'7 freshman out of Cyprus, will come back and answer immediately. 15-10, minute 19 to go. Long 3-point shot, way off, no good by TJC, but right there with the rebound is Isabello. Top of the key, now penetrating down the paint and getting fouled hard on the way to the rim. It's going to be Amari Welch. Welch, a 5'6 freshman out of Canton. And Amari Welch may possibly be, since being from Canton, may possibly be some kin to TJC and Canton High School legend Pooh Welch somewhere down the line, I've been led to believe. Minute 9 to go, and in and out on the free throw by Amari Welch. And it will fall out. 5-point advantage for Blinn right now. Game 2 of our 4-game slate of women's games this afternoon. And free throw is in for Welch. It's a 4-point ball game. 15-11. And rotating the basketball in and out. And great defensive play coming in the back door. Fontecone will sneak in the back door and knock what was sure to be an easy layup out of bounds with the pass attempt going inside to Blinn. Inbound pass, forcing up a tough shot and getting it to go is Singleton. Wow. Body connections all over the place. Now bouncing it back outside is Kone. And a foul called away from the basketball. And it'll be a defensive foul going to be called this time on Takar Johnson. Johnson, her first foul call. Fourth team foul against Blinn. So with 46 and a half seconds to go, TJC will check in Tasha Bostic, 5'10 sophomore out of Quitman, Mississippi. And Blinn will check in Winter Jones back in the basketball game. Backing it back out will be Jackson. Kamora Jackson rotating it over to, well, about it, as soon as it got to Isabello, she tried to work the ball around a defender. Defender kind of tipped her arm while she was trying to go down with the dribble. She took an extra step while that was happening, and she'll get called for the travel. Turnover TJC. 32 seconds to go. A 6-point lead for the Buccaneers of Blinn College. Back and forth, rotating the basketball. Setting the pick, top side is Johnson. Over to Jones. Jones to the right side wing. It'll go to Mathis. Back inside the circle, now double team. Back in, 3-point shot, thought about. Rotating the basketball, great defensive play. And, well, the officials in game one were allowing a lot of physicality with those two basketball teams playing in Angelina and Coastal Bend. But officials in game two playing a little bit tighter. These girls are going to have to get used to what's going on in front of them and try to combat that with the nature of the calls for the officials. So free throws again for Blinn, and Blinn is making good on almost all of these. Neal will go to the free throw line as Jonisha Neal, 5'4 freshman out of Houston. Neal averaging 6.5 points a night. She's a 63% free throw shooter, but she's 100% this trip. As down, we'll push it to a 8-point lead for Blinn with 12 seconds to go in the first period. TJC getting it across midcourt at the 9-second mark. Top of the key, Kone dribbling around. She's got 2.5 seconds. Somebody's got to put up a shot, and they do at the buzzer, and they get the bucket. How about that? Bertha with a nice pass inside by Isabello gets the assist in the basket. It's a 19-13 first quarter for Blinn. As second quarter coming up next, 10 minutes to go, 19-13 lead for Blinn over TJC when we return. 23, Chelsea Singleton. Just
Just this reminder, folks, that this will be the conclusion of this first session of this day number two, and we're going to clear the gym after the game, and we'll announce sometime later in the game when the gym will reopen. But again, plan to be making your way out at the end of this game.
Second quarter gets underway with Blinn College up by 6, 19-13. As they pick up a basket, TJC picks up a basket at the buzzer. Down into the right side corner, Blinn and TJC. Boy, defensively, a good battle going on right now. A lot of physicality, 2-3 zone defense for TJC. And a wide open three-pointer is up by Mathis, and she pops it from the right corner.
Tiana
Mathis, a 5'8 sophomore out of Bryan, Texas, moves the lead to 9 with that three-pointer. Kone inside, triple team. Down to Bertho. Fanishka Bertho, a 6'5 freshman out of Miami, Florida. And yes, she is a physical presence underneath the basket. Bertho sits at the free throw line to try to bring TJC back to within 7. 22-13, she will miss the free throw. Bertho averaging 6.2 points a night, and she is a 42% free throw shooter from the line this season. Sets, shoots off on the second one. Rebound pulled down by Johnson. Johnson rips it down. Up court quickly to Mathis. Mathis knifes through three defenders. Outlet pass to Walton. Walton rotates it back. Three-point shot trying to answer and no good by Winter Jones. And TJC with the rebound by Bertho. And here comes the Apache women. Up the right side. Losing the basketball. Double-teamed and will not get the foul drawn. Mathis out to the wing. Long three-pointer. Walton short. No good. Long rebound. Free throw line extended. Pass down to the right baseline is no good. Left baseline missed by Johnson. So no help underneath the boards. And Blinn will turn it back over to TJC. Anderson retaining the dribble for TJC. Back top of the key to Kone. Now inside to Bertho. And Bertho getting double teamed. We're going to get a call on the floor as a hold from behind the play.
Takara Johnson.
So it looks like Johnson will get called for the foul behind Bertho. So Jasmine Jackson and Kincaid back on the floor for Blinn. And coming off is Kamora Jackson. And back on the floor is Amari Welch for TJC. Inside to Bertho. Bertho spin move. Tries to reach around two defenders, keeping the basketball up over her head. And a strong conversion on the right side glass. 22-15 Blinn. Going up for the shot attempt. Bertho had it what she thought was pulling the block down, forcing Trina Tillisport to dance a little bit on the sideline. And not happy that they didn't get away with that one, but Bertho with her hands straight up and really looked like for a second there. Possibility the shooter, which now we find out is Kincaid. So DJ Kincaid, 5'9", freshman out of Tyler's Chapel Hill High School. Kincaid went right up into Bertho, who really just stopped the shot and held on to the football, to the basketball, and got called for the foul. It's her first personal foul, first team foul for TJC in the second quarter. 8:12 to go in the second period. And Isabello will sit down. And checking back in the ballgame is Kamora Jackson. Jackson and Welch will bring the basketball up. Pass over right side to Anderson. Rotates to the middle of the court. Left side over to Jefferson. Jefferson gets it back. Top of the key. Now driving, penetrates inside the blocks. Long off the top of the rim. Oh, goodness. Well, Jeff Jenkins is asking, you know what? That ball pretty much hit the support, but it looked like it just dinked the very corner of the top of the backboard and fell back in. Stolen away by TJC. Apaches with a 2-on-3 break and a backside pass. It'll go back beyond the arc. Dumped off inside to Bertho. Spin move to the right. Shots up and good. Bertho with the turnaround. Spun around to the right side and no defender in front of her. 5-point ball game. 24-19. Blinn College leading TJC here early in this second period. 3-point shot. It's a long one. Off the rim. No good. TJC. Bertho up with the rebound. Outlet pass to Jefferson. Jefferson across midcourt. Alexandria Jefferson, 5'6 freshman, dumps off inside and the foul. Bucket and one coming down to Anderson. Sage Anderson gets a call inside and will take it to the line to try to finish up a 3-point play and possibly bring TJC back to within two. 24-21. Tyler Junior College. And the Apache women. Ball is off, no good, and it goes off the fingertips of two Blinn Buccaneers fighting for the rebound. And teammates look at each other and shake their heads as TJC will get second chance points here with an inbound underneath their own basket. Down by three, 24-21. Blinn holding on to it. Lead was 9 moments ago. Outlet pass to Jefferson. Inside the circle. Loses the dribble. Picked back up. Jefferson with a long three. Launched the air ball. Will go out of bounds. And Jefferson knew it as soon as it left her hands because she took off trying to catch up with the basketball before it went out of bounds. So possible lost opportunity there even though TJC picked up a bucket. 24-21, 3-point lead. Blinn trying to reset. Top of the key to Johnson. Johnson down left side to Neal. Neal gives it off. Shots up and good. Popping the three-pointer deep in that left side baseline corner. Singleton hits the three to extend the lead back to 6. Three-pointer. Jefferson's going to answer. How about that? Alexandria Jefferson answers with a three of her own. Inside pass. Back outside. Right side wing. No good on the three-pointer. TJC with a rebound. Crowd starting to come alive in this one for the home team. TJC Apache women. Jefferson into the wing to Jackson. Inside to Bertho. Back out to Jackson. Jackson will penetrate now. Takes it to the hole. Hard to the hole. And an offensive player control foul as Kamora Jackson took it hard to the hole and went right over the top of Janisha Neal for the foul call. So Nala Richardson back on the court now for Blinn. And the Buccaneers holding a 3-point lead, 27-24. Fantastic start here to game two of the NJCAA Regional Championship and the women's semis, or the women's quarterfinals, excuse me. Long 3-point shot, right side corner, no good. Bertho fighting for the rebound and pulls it down. Bertho looking for someone to pass it to. Finally gets it off to Jefferson, and Jefferson will now bounce it up court, gets it up to Welch. Welch brings it across and sets the offense for TJC. Off the right side, Jefferson will penetrate. Pull-up jump shot. Jumper is no good. Foul called on the drive. And that looks like that's going to go against Janisha Neal. So Neal's first foul of the afternoon.
Alexandria Jefferson shooting 2 shots.
So Jefferson at the free throw line. Jefferson hitting 5 points average on the night brings TJC to within 2. 27-25. She is only 7 of 10 from the free throw line this season. Misses the second. Rebound comes down into the hands of Blinn College's Tiana Mathis. Mathis gets it across court. Blinn's going to reset their offense. Way outside to Singleton. Singleton left side wing now penetrating and putting up the teardrop. No good by Neal. And Neal gives it back to TJC. Here comes Jefferson across midcourt. Down the right side, a reset to the left side to Welch. Welch looking for some spacing and gets it. Over to Jefferson, right side wing. Bertho trying to post up inside. And the drive, and we're going to get an, I think, an offensive player control foul. A push-off is going to be called against Bertho underneath. As Bertho evidently got a little bit too physical underneath. Media timeouts from the scores table. 4:42 and a scrambling heck of a second quarter. 27-25 Blinn when we return. Out of the media timeout, it's Blinn Buccaneer basketball. As the Buccaneers behind Jeff Jenkins, who has been here for a while and doing it very well. Inside the circle, turnaround jump shot, 16 feet, no good. Out of bounds off of TJC. Jeff Jenkins has had one heck of a career. Continues his long history of success here in his 23rd season in Brenham. Outlet pass for Blinn. 17 seconds. It'll be a floater from the free throw line. Will go plus a foul. Kamora Jackson was the closest one to her, and I think that's where they're going to call the foul.
Personal foul. Tyler, team foul number four.
So Neal puts up what looks like a crazy shot at first, but gets pounded by Kamora Jackson, knocks her to the floor, and she'll get free throws. And shot is up and good, so we'll finish the three-point play for Neal. And Janisha Neal pushes it back to a five-point advantage for Blinn. 30-25. Jefferson with the basketball for TJC. The Apache women on the attack. Top of the key to Anderson. Anderson penetrates, has to save it. Over to Jefferson. Jefferson with the long three is long. Rebound right into the hands of Mathis for Blinn. Mathis going to bring it across half court. Welch is working her on defense. 1-3-1 breakdown zone. Long shot is no good, and getting her own rebound. And the putback is Johnson. A fantastic play by Takara Johnson. 5'11 freshman out of Crockett. She missed the shot badly, but followed it. Ball went right back into her hands off the backboard. She got the putback to move the lead to 7. Three-point shot is pounded from the outside. Oh, my. Sage Anderson will come back with a three of her own. Four-point lead for Blinn, 32-28. Penetration. A lot of contact. Ball knocked around. Jefferson ends up with the rebound. And a little bit of an off-balance shot by Mathis on the drive. Jefferson one-handed. Shot. Welch. Three-pointer is in. Back-to-back trays by the Apache women. It's a one-point ball game. 32-31 with 2:58 to go in the first half. Fantastic back and forth from the 4 and 5 seed. Spot up three-pointer for Blinn. No good. TJC trying to slap it out of there. Double teaming inside and slinging an elbow into the face of Welch. And Trina Tillis-Hort is losing her mind. As coming up hard and away from her body with that elbow was Johnson. And Welch will get a corner of that elbow. And Trina Tillis-Hort came off of that bench like she was launched. So a foul is actually going to be called on Amari Welch. Welch will get the foul call as she was defending Takara Johnson. Johnson came up high with that elbow, trying to wrestle the ball away. And now the officials are conferring. You can see them in the camera shot here in a second off to the left side. But they're talking inside the circle. But I don't think they're talking about the foul call that just got called. 2:45, clock is stopped to go in the first half. It's a one-point ball game, 32-31. Be interested to get these numbers. Now the officials are walking to the scorer's table. And Trina Tillis-Hort absolutely wants to talk about that foul call. As they're talking to Jimmy Hicks at the scorer's table, this is an incredibly experienced scorer's table here at Tyler Junior College for this regional tournament. As a lot of the locals will tell you here, this is the A-team working this tournament. TJC with a fantastic hosting job going on right now with this university, with the setup, with the hospitality, with the personalities that are involved in this basketball tournament. And you have to have people that are basketball people and also those that enjoy the game, but know how to organize and know how to put their foot down when they have to. With local and road media in and out of here, and coaches and staffs and players.
So we have the original foul, Amari Welch. Since that's the 15 foul, we'll have free throws. But then we have an intentional foul on Blinn, so we'll go to the other end and shoot after.
All right, well, thank you, Jason Pointer, for correcting all that for us. So Amari Welch will get called for her first personal foul of the afternoon. And at the line shooting the free throws is Takara Johnson, who also will be called for her third personal foul on that intentional foul. She's got 3 points as she will knock in the free throw. Johnson will set up for her next one. And the second one is up and good. So she'll score two and then go down to the other side with the intentional foul shots that are about to be attempted, I think, by Welch.
We'll send Amari Welch.
So Welch will get a chance to get some points out of that. As fortunately, she did not catch but just a glancing blow of that elbow that got thrown by Takari Johnson. So Takara got her two on her end, and Welch has scored one and now make that two. So it remains a one-point ball game. Each team got 2 points, and TJC gets the basketball back after the free throws, as the intentional foul treated much like a technical foul. So they will get the basketball back with a one-point deficit right now. Apache Women, left side. Jefferson gets it just taken away from her at the top of the key. Spinning out of that is Singleton with the takeaway. Dumps it off inside, high off the glass, no good. But a foul call, I think, by Jefferson. Possibly a little frustration foul there, and it will be called against Alexandria Jefferson, the 5'6 freshman out of Atlanta, Texas. And her first personal of the afternoon. Both teams hit their 5 team fouls a while back. Free throw is short and no good. The attempt up there by Nala Richardson. Richardson, a 67% free throw shooter. She's averaging 5.5 points a night. She gets 1 out of 2 on that visit. And substitutions in for TJC is Kimora Jackson. And back on the floor for Blinn is Janiyah Thomas. And timeout on the floor will be a 30-second timeout with 2:28 to go in the first half. Blinn with a 2-point lead after the free throws there by Richardson. Early game, Angelina over Coastal Bend by a bunch, as the number one seed will move on to play on Friday in game one for the women, which will be scheduled at 1 o'clock on Friday. And Blinn and Tyler, winner, will play Angelina at that 1 o'clock contest in the semifinal round on Fridays. Getting set for the championship games on Saturday. And for those setting their schedule, championship games will be scheduled for 4 and 7 o'clock. 35-33 Blinn. 2:22 to go. TJC basketball. Way out top of the key and looking to dump it off inside. We're going to get a foul away from the ball. Poe's going inside. Thomas will get the foul call on her, Janae Thomas. So Janaya Thomas with her first personal foul. And going to sit Kone at the free throw line now. Fonta Kone sets. A lot of dribbles. And shot is up and good. Kone's averaging 7.5 points a night. She is fourth on this team in scoring. Kone making them both. Kone, 18 of 24. She's a 75% free throw shooter on the season. So Kone ties it up at 35. This was a 9-point Blinn advantage at one time. TJC fighting their way back here in the first half. Pretty big second quarter as well. Rotating a basketball, to Richardson's got to pull it back out with 9 seconds on the shot clock. Trying to penetrate, taking it right to the hole and forcing up a shot and getting the foul called. Grace Isabello. We'll get the foul called. Finally just taking it to the hole was Jasmine Jackson. She saw a little bit of an alley and was able to penetrate all the way into the middle of the paint before any defensive pressure by Isabello, and she's going to have to come out of the game. She'll check out now, but on her first foul call, assistant coach Brandon Taylor is over talking to her about her defensive posture, talking to her about setting up her area a lot sooner. First free throw is in, second one in as well. So Janisha Neal will knock down both free throws, 37-35. Blinn ahead by a bucket with a minute 44 to go. TJC trying to keep pace. Top of the key, it'll go to Bostic. Bostic trying to set a pick up high. And Bostic now will get called for a leg out moving pick. She sets a screen outside the circle, and Bostic evidently just moved her knee out a little bit. Try to interfere with the defender rolling around her, and will get called for the foul, her first personal foul. Blinn outside, long three-point shot. Richardson in and out, no good. Reaching for the rebound, and finally pulling it down is Bostic. Bostic off to Welch. Welch around the back, dribble to get it across midcourt, and will set the offense for TJC. Spin move back to the right. Inside the circle, down to the baseline, right side to Bostic. Bostic looking inside, nobody in the paint. Has to bounce it back to Kone. Kone will now penetrate. Outlet, long three-point shot off, no good. Shot missed by Jackson, but run down by Kone. Kone back across Jackson, wide open three again, inside and out, no good. Well, TJC, I think, was pretty sure that was their basketball on the tip out of bounds, but it will stay with the Blinn Buccaneers, and they will get the basketball back with 49 seconds to go. Shot clock down to 20. Blinn penetrating. Back outlet pass, right side. Down into the wing to Mathis. Mathis dribbles it right back out. Down into the corner, penetrating corner, and a lot of body contact, and now a foul called. As the trail official will make a foul call with the lead official right next to the foul itself. So Fonta Kone turned to the trail official since he was right next to him, who did not blow the whistle, and was asking him, what did I do? So the body contact kind of forced a redirection for Neal. And that's how she will draw the foul. Neal will knock down the free throw to move the lead back to 3 points. Neal will move the lead to 4 points. So Janisha Neal, a 5'4 freshman out of Houston, is by herself at the free throw line, giving Blinn a 4-point lead. 39-35, 28 seconds to go, first half. Tyler Junior College trying to get off a last-ditch effort here. Only about a half a second difference in game clock and shot clock. Kone inside to Bertho. Bertho, spin move, dumps it off. Short jump shot on the right side wing, no good. Rebound, Welch, resets it. 9 seconds to go, shot clock is off. Welch, pull-up jump shot inside the circle. Will miss, went down looking for the foul call. Rebound, Bertho puts it up, miss shot. Clock will expire. So a couple of shot opportunities for TJC do not fall. And Blinn will take a four-point lead in at the half. Number four seed over the number five seed, 39-35. Blinn over the TJC Apaches when we return. We'll give you some halftime numbers when we come back. You're listening to the NJCAA Regional Women's Championships today on the TJC Apache Broadcast Network.
It looks like 6 points are going to lead the Apache ladies with Alexandria Jefferson off the bench. Now coming up, after we finish this game, we're going to clear the gym and then we're going to be back for more of the first round ladies action here at Region 14. Later on this evening, we have the Lady Cardinals from Trinity Valley as the number two seed. They'll play the Lady Dragons from Harris at 6. And then the 3 and 6 seeds, Kilmore and Panola, the Phillies, against Kilmore. Those two winners will play each other on Thursday.
Back at Wagstaff Gymnasium, we are at the half. Game two of our four-game slates of women's quarterfinal games going on. TJC trailing Blinn right now. Blinn Buccaneers 39, TJC 35. For Blinn, top scorers and leading scorer for the game right now, 13 points for Janisha Neal. Neal with 13 points, 4 assists to her credit, also a steal and a couple of rebounds to her credit. The only other one in double figures in the game is Chelsea Singleton. Singleton with 10 points She's got a couple of boards also to her credit and two steals. 2 for 3 from beyond the arc. She's 4 of 8 from the field thus far. 10 points for Singleton. Rounding out the scoring, 5 points, 2 rebounds right now for Tiana Mathis, also for Blinn College. They're 3 of 9 from the three-point line. They're shooting 32% from the field. 3 of 9 once again from three-point and 20 for 24 from the free throw line in the first half. Let's go over that again. 20 for 24 from the free throw line in the first half. 11 for 11 is Janisha Neal at the free throw line. A little crazy looking at those numbers. Only one bucket, but 11 points from the free throw line. Right now, it may be the difference in this game. TJC with 4 players with 6 points right now in Jackson, Bertho, Welch, and Jefferson, all with 6 points. Jefferson with 6 points, a couple of rebounds, and an assist. 6 points and 3 rebounds right now for Amari Welch. 6 points, 5 rebounds for Bertho right now, who's having a pretty darn strong game inside. They have nobody to compete with her at Blinn right now, size-wise and strength-wise, underneath the basket. 6 points, 2 rebounds, and a couple of assists right now for Lillian Jackson. And other big numbers, 3 assists right now also for Amari Welch as well. They're 3 for 9 from beyond the arc, matching that with Blinn. Both teams 3 of 9. And looking at 11 turnovers for TJC and 6 right now for the Blinn College Buccaneer women. 13 and 22, the points first and second quarter for TJC. 19 and 20, first to second quarter points for Blinn College right now. It's a 39-35 lead for Blinn. We'll take a timeout. Second half tip-off about 8 minutes away when we return. You're listening to the NJCAA Regional Basketball Championships from Wagstaff Gymnasium in Tyler on the TJC Apache Broadcast Network.
I told them it's all in the wrist. They want me to miss it, that's what I wish.
39-35. Ten points for Chelsea Singleton, for Blinn, 13 for Jonesha Neal. Three players with 6 points for the Apache ladies, Welch, Bertho, and Jefferson. Third quarter, TJC's ball.
Second half gets underway, TJC and Blinn. Blinn College leading by 4, 39-35 to start the second half. And if this ends anyway, the way the first two quarters went, it will be a barn burner here to finish out this ball game. One team will move on and play Friday and possibly on Saturday if they can stay alive. And the other team will start their spring break on a Wednesday. So both of these teams are in battle mode as of right now. TJC takes it right to the bucket as Gracie Zabilo, a 6'1 freshman out of Nigeria, Africa, will take it right to the hole, draws the foul, and will set them up and draw them back to within three. 39-36 on the free throws by Isabilo. And she will one in, one out. One for one that time in that particular trip. But, boy, they are way behind when it comes to free throws as Blinn once again, 20 of 24 from the free throw line. Block shot from behind, getting the basketball back and unable to get back-to-back blocks. And the foul going to be called on Lillian Jackson, but wow, Bennett with a fantastic block. Kiana Bennett in with a block on the shot attempt by Nala Richardson, who goes to the free throw line. And Blinn has just kind of like set up a canoe and a tent right there at the free throw line this afternoon. And she'll miss the front end of the free throw. So both teams have already been to the free throw line mere seconds into this second half. First 23 seconds, two fouls. In and out, and buzzer sounds right as the free throw hits the rim.
Bertho heading back in for the Apache ladies. Giving Lillian Jackson a break.
So, Finiska Bertho checking back in for TJC, in for Lillian Jackson. So, inbound after the miss, goes out of bounds. Off of TJC, and that shot's up and good, and that one goes down by Chelsea Singleton. So Singleton gets the dose back for Blinn, and missing the basket completely on the drive is DK. So Kalichi DK, 5'10 freshman out of Sugarland, takes it right inside the circle just in front of the free throw line and misses everything on the errant shot. 41-36, 5-point lead now for Blinn. Jump step and sits down, and an offensive foul going to be called. And this time on Jasmine Jackson. Jackson, the 6'3 sophomore out of Cyprus.
Our second, team second. New player for TJC, number 5, Kamora Jackson.
So at the half, 39-35. And early in this third period, a bucket and a free throw for Blinn and TJC respectively, puts it at 41-36. Rotating it, top of the key, long three-point shot, in and out, no good. Rebound pulled down, and aggressively as Isabilo pulls down the rebound and gets the putback for TJC on the miss on the shot from Bennett. Blinn back down, three-point game, Blinn over TJC. Pushing and penetrating is Mathis. Mathis now has to dribble back out with 14 on the shot clock. They're going to reset outside to Singleton. Singleton now will penetrate. Pull-up jump shot. Free throw line is off. No good. Rebound into the hands of Kone. And Fontekone brings it down court left side. We'll take it to the top of the key to Bennett. Bennett will fake inside the circle. Spins back to her right side. Pull-up jump shot. Free throw line extended right corner. No good. That time by Isabilo. And ball will go out of bounds off of Bertha trying for the rebound. Three-point ball game early in this third period. Winner of this ball game will move on to play Angelina at 1 o'clock on Friday in the semis to see who will head to the championship round. Three-point shot, long, no good. Rebound way up top from Isabilo. So Blinn coming out a little cold here in the second half. As Kone Reverses it back to the right side. Now they'll get it inside to Bertho. Bertho turns around high up the glass and can't get it to fall. Isabelo with the rebound. TJC with a fresh shot clock. Isabelo now spin move to her right, back to her left, and over by the baseline. Outlet pass, long three-pointer, in and out. No good by Jackson. Long rebound, Blinn. Here comes Blinn, and stopping the dribble. And great defense by Kimora Jackson, but got a little bit too much body contact as she reached the three-point line, and we'll get the foul called.
Kimora Jackson with her.
And Welch will check back in the ball game. Jasmine Jackson will sit down for Blinn. And checking back in the game here in the second half will be Takara Johnson. Johnson on the court now for Blinn. Penetration and leaving her alone for an open basket. On the right side is Janisha Neal. Neal third on this team in scoring with 6.5 points a night. And Neal is killing it this afternoon. Welch, three-pointer is good.
Three-pointer for Amari Welch.
So Welch will knock it down from a tray to bring TJC to within two. 43-41 Blinn. Blinn continues to work that left side. Neal loses the basketball, dribbles into traffic, and finally a tie basketball. As Neal was trapped down just outside the blocks. And Jasmine Jackson will sit down, and Elizabeth Walton checks in now for Blinn. And this time Isabelo will sit down, and Morgan back on the floor for TJC. Shalane Morgan. Blinn will inbound. Head fake to the right, going back to the left side is Singleton. Singleton will wrestle it back. Long two-point shot inside the circle, no good. Rebound pulled down that time by Kone. Montekone brings it back the other side of the court and out of bounds on a nice hustle play by Walton to gather it up out of bounds. TJC will inbound on the far side of the court. Inbounding will be Welch. Welch inside. Just mid-cross, mid-court. Off the fingertips on the pass attempt. Missed by Bennett. Turnover will go into the hands of Blinn. So Buccaneers come back the other side of the court with Neal. Holding her dribble. Now over to the right side. Gets the ball back. Top of the key. Trying to reverse it. Now we'll go down the middle. Gets a block on the top side by Johnson. Now we'll give it up, spin move, losing the basketball over to Walton, and Walton, foul's going to be called. No, travel call inside the circle. Well, Walton got the ball kind of slapped in midair, but she never actually let it go.
Number three, Winter Jones.
And came back down with the basketball while she was still moving her feet. So turnover against Blinn. 43-41, Buccaneers, 6:05 to go third quarter. Kone penetrating down the baseline. Outlet pass, long three-pointer. Welch is open. Round the rim three times and in! Well, Welch really drawing the dramatics right there. High hip bounce off the rim. Double bounce back and forth. Kisses the glass and falls in. TJC with their first lead since the first 2 minutes of the basketball game, 44-43, TJC. Working her way down the right side. Neal throws up a three of her own, long, and rebound pulled down by Isabelo. Checking in, Winter Jones back on the floor from Dallas. Jones will defend now on Kone. Kone and Jones. Jones trying to keep her from going to their left side. Three-point shot again, this time by Welch is long, no good. Ball loose on the ground, and a little contact from behind as Bertho will bump into the backside of Johnson and knock her down and draw the foul. So Bertho, unfortunately, just picked up her third personal foul here with 5:03 to go in the third period. So Janae Thomas checking back in. Janaya Thomas, excuse me, for Blinn. And back on the floor. Let's see, Bennett back on the floor. Also Bertho. Welch. Missed by Blinn. Out of bounds. And ball will go off the fingertips of Isabelo. And will stay on the side of the court for the Blinn Buccaneers. So whistle blows. Media timeouts. 4:48 to go, third period, and we come back. NJCAA Regional Championships and first round for the women in day two here at Wagstaff in Tyler when we return. Back to live action at Wagstaff, and intercepting the inbound pass is Kone. Kone coming back the other way for TJC. The Apache women right now nursing a one-point lead, 44-43, in a back-and-forth affair here at Wagstaff in game two of the day. And bumping and grinding going on inside the paints between Johnson and Bertho, and battling it back and forth. And this time it'll be the Apaches that will force Johnson into a fourth personal foul here, third team foul against Blinn here in the third quarter. 4:34 to go, TJC to inbound. Top of the key to Kone, pass in from Bennett. Over to Isabello. Isabello hands off to Bennett. Bennett back down the right side, left side baseline, and Kone throws up a wild shot, draws the foul. Well, Kone was so far behind the backboard, the only choice she had was to just try to reach back into the court and lay it up and possibly draw the foul, and she did that nicely. So TJC finding themselves at the free throw line almost as much as Blinn did in the first half. Now here early in this third period, shot is up and good by Kone, extending the Apache woman lead to two, 45-43. Kone sitting back up, 18-24 on the season, 75% from the free throw line. She makes them both. So Kone making them both. Bertho will sit back down, and Bostic checking back in for Finishka Bertho. Daisha Bostic, 5'10 sophomore out of Quitman, Mississippi. Blinn basketball. Walton getting it back and forth between Jackson and forcing the shot up, but drawing the foul and taking a foul a little bit up high. It'll be Welch a little bit called for the foul. And Welch actually fouled her on the floor. So fourth team foul. Four team fouls on both teams this afternoon. Second personal foul on Welch. Inbound to Walton. Walton penetrates, spin move to her right, goes high off the glass. Great move by Walton. Elizabeth Walton, 5'7", freshman. As Walton finished the first half with a bucket, with a single point, a couple of rebounds. Walton out with the bucket on the good spin move, freeing herself away from the defense. Isabella wants to go the baseline. Outlet pass to Welch. Welch squared up for a three. Pull-up jump shot, free throw line, no good. Tapped around, Isabella will tip it right into the hands of Winter Jones. Winter Jones brings it back the other way for Blinn. Taps it back, pull-up jump shot, 18-foot, no good for Jackson. Jasmine Jackson with the miss, but Blinn will get the rebound and gets a free shot clock. Another shot clock, compliments of Singleton. Singleton gets it back, free throw line inside to Kincaid. Kincaid will miss the shot. Another shot clock they get, and a rebound pulled down and one situation for Jasmine Jackson. Well, a fantastic physical possession here for the Blinn Buccaneers as they continue to fight for the basketball on the offensive end, and they regain the lead 47-46 here on the and-one workout that Jasmine Jackson just put in, a 6'3 sophomore out of Cypress. And Jackson right now trying to push this lead to a bucket, and she does. Jackson with the bucket will move the Blinn lead back to 48-46. And trying to get Bertho on the court before the ball goes live, and they will not get it. But TJC will inbound down by two. 48-46. Blinn and TJC just going at it and losing the basketball out of bounds. And that time just Fontacone just looked a little bit out of control as she was heading down the baseline and literally just ran out of room to run and just ran out of bounds and lost the basketball. So turnover TJC, and Blinn gets it back with a two-point lead. Spin move off the baseline, picking it up inside the paint, and got to let it loose. Ball is loose on the ground. Blinn almost with an unforced error. They'll retain possession. 10 on the shot clock, all the way back out to midcourt. Kone working winner Jones. Only four on the shot clock. Jones has got to drive and try to draw a foul. She goes down hard. And TJC and even the fans on this side of the court are wondering where the contact was. It looked like Winter Jones may have just tripped and fallen down or was trying to draw the foul. And there are times when, well, these girls can sell it. Where if there's a bit of contact or they're off balance at all, as long as they touch an opposing player's body and go down, it is not difficult to get a foul call in these situations. Clock stopped at 2:32 to go in the third period. And making both free throws is Winter Jones, and she gets to go to the bench, take a little breather. Janisha Neal back in the basketball game. Four-point lead for Blinn. TJC had a temporary two-point lead moments ago, and Blinn worked their way back and are now up by four. Kone cross court over to Jackson. Jackson back to Kone. Jackson gets it back. Jump step, little Euro step. Shot goes off, no good. Isabello gets the ball back. Offensive rebound, no good. Put back temp, no good. Foul call. Lillian Jackson stayed on the right side and blocked everybody out on the left side of the basket while Isabello was putting up the tempted shot, so in perfect position for a rebound. But neither shot will fall. They end up with three possessions or three possibilities at a bucket there and cannot get them to fall. They'll get the foul call, but they'll get some points from the charity stripe. As popping it and watching it fall down is Lillian Jackson, the 5'11 sophomore. Jackson, the second leading scorer on this basketball team with 9 points a night. She is a 67% free throw shooter. Misses the second, 50-47. And foul called immediately on Kone. So Fontacone with her third personal foul, and all of a sudden, Coach Trina Tillis-Horde is into rotation mode now with trying to protect some players in foul trouble with three now, with 2:02 to go in the third quarter. Free throw in and out, around the rim and out for Chelsea Singleton. Singleton leads his team in scoring with 13.7 points a night. Singleton will miss them both. It's a 72% free throw shooter. And Isabello is about to, she's losing her composure a bit, and Trina Tillis-Horde puts two fingers over her lips and tells her to be quiet and get down the court. So evidently, there was a little bit of an errant elbow that was thrown in the scrum there. Just two players wrestling for the basketball. And free throws are up and good. And as soon as I can look through the extensions here on the hair, I think that's going to be Kincaid at the free throw line. She hits the front end to move the lead to four, 51-47. And off on the second one, off the inside of the iron. TJC with the rebound. And good blocking out job for DK. And here comes TJC. He's a Bilo, top of the key to Kone. They'll rotate her back around to Welch. And boy, everybody gets in Welch's face. A good three-point shooter. Walton jumped right out on her. 51-47. Minute 40 to go, third quarter. Long three-point shot, short, no good. Great rebound. DK comes up with a rebound. Welch, open for three, in and out, no good. Rebound down into the hands of Neal. Here comes Janisha Neal. Neal up court to Walton. Walton puts a shoulder down and right into the heart of DK. And DK will draw the charging foul. Bertho comes up off the bench, checks in for Isabello. For TJC, for Blinn, Richardson back on the court. Mathis comes back in the court. And sitting down will be Walton and Kincaid for Blinn. Well, a couple of teams that have a lot of respect for each other, coaching staffs as well, and they are battling it out here at Wagstaff. Game two of our four-game slate for today. Stolen away, tapped right back to TJC. 10 on the shot clock, minute 05 to go in the third quarter clock. Kone picks up her dribble outside. Welch from way downtown, short. Foul's going to be called on the shot. It will not be called on the shot. It'll be a foul away from the basketball underneath the bucket. Bertho gets called for her fourth personal foul away from the ball on the Welch miss on the three-pointer. So Bertho checks in the game and immediately is called for a body, pretty much a body check in the paint. But she will stay on the floor now with 55 seconds to go in the third quarter. Bertho set up in the middle. Pass inside. Missing the lay in on the left side. Saving the basketball. Blinn still on top of it. Ball loose. Great effort. Underneath the basket by Nala Richardson. Richardson missed the shot and then somehow saved the basketball from going out of bounds. Blinn fell on it and immediately yelled timeout. And they'll pick it up. It'll be a 30-second timeout for Jeff Jenkins and the Buccaneers. Well, Jenkins 447 and 223 at Blinn, making him the winningest coach in program history, and he continues to grow those numbers. The Buccaneers ended their season last year ranked third nationally, finishing the year at 31-4 overall, and finished claiming their second consecutive Region 14 co-championship with a 15-1 mark. The only conference opponent, as I mentioned before, to sweep them this season, Tyler Junior College Apache Women. So to come here and to work out a little payback for Blinn Buccaneers, this is an important contest for the rest of this third quarter and the fourth quarter as well. For TJC, Trina Tillis-Horde does not like going home from her own home gym. She likes playing in championship games. So this will be a fantastic final 10-plus minutes of basketball. Blinn will inbound underneath their own basket. Toss it inside, short jump shot, in and out, no good. Rebound pulled down by Isabello and a foul called immediately. Boy, there is a lot of whistles in this basketball game.
Free throws will be coming.
Well, Nala Richardson will get called for the foul. It'll be her first personal foul.
For Grace Isabello.
So Isabello will go to the free throw line.
13, Dasha Bostic. Checking in for Vanessa Bertho. And number two, Shane Bostic
will come in for Bertho.
Coming in for the Apache ladies, giving Fanta Kone.
And Bostic checking back in for Kone. Isabello at the free throw line and will hit the front end. Isabello with 8 points right now. As third quarter coming to a close, 39 and a half seconds to go in this third period. And nice work at the free throw line by Isabello, as she will make them both. Driving the baseline, almost losing her dribble, but picking it back up is Neal. Neal gets the basketball off. Double teaming and getting called for the travel. Coming across the paint is going to be Richardson. So Nala Richardson, looked like she had an outlet pass. And Coach Trina Tillis-Horde was trying her best to get Bennett up off the bench and get her checked in ASAP. And Bennett finally will get checked back into the basketball game for Bostic. And here comes TJC, down by two, 51-49, 20 seconds to go. Shot clock is off to go in the third quarter. Isabello looking to hand off. Picks up her dribble, hands it off. 10 seconds to go. Short two-pointer, no good. Run down by Blinn. Blinn picks it back up. Singleton will push it quickly. 2 seconds to go. Tries the drive. Can't get the shot to go. Rebound, TJC. And we will head to the fourth quarter. Blinn up 51-49 over TJC Apache Women. NJCAA Regional Championships in the women's quarterfinal. Game two of our four-game slate today. And this is coming down to the final 10 minutes. Blinn 51, TJC 49 when we return.
Please remember that at the conclusion of this game, that we will clear the gym and reopen at 5:30. Clearing the gym, reopening at 5:30. So you can come back and watch two more fantastic ladies' games. Fourth quarter, TJC's ball.
Jason Pointer reminding the home audience that we'll be clearing the gym after this ball game. Two more to go at 6 and 8 o'clock. This evening, Manny Almanza will be on the call for you right here in this chair. Blinn College up 51-49 over Tyler Junior College, the host school. See who wants to go to the next round on Friday. Kone inside. Turn around, roll in is Bertho. Bertho with just a rocket. She barely got her hands on the basketball and spun lightning quick as she can to the left. Off the glass, rolls it in over the front side of the rim. Tied up at 51. Blinn coming the other way, penetrating down the baseline. Going in heavy, Bertho will have to sit down as she has just committed her fifth personal foul. Driving right at her, coming down the baseline and taking it right at Bertho is Singleton. Chelsea Singleton will go to the line as she takes it right at TJC's strong weapon inside the paint. And we'll sit Bertho down. Fanishka Bertho, 6'5 freshman, will sit down. After committing her fifth personal foul, she will foul out with 9:24 to go in this ball game. And free throw is up and good. It's Blinn by one. We will take a bit of a intermission after this ball game and come back with our two evening games, Trinity Valley and Paris scoring off at 6 o'clock, and at 8 o'clock it's Kilgore and Panola, 3 and 6 seed, coming up at 8 o'clock. So Thai basketball will stay on the ground and keep it on Blinn's side of the basketball court. Blinn will inbound. Long three-point shot is up and good. Did they give her the three? They gave her the two. As coming down with the tray with the two is Singleton, who's right on the line. So Singleton making her presence known here in the fourth period. Stolen away by Blinn. No, jumping on it and falling on top of it is DK. DK, who got it stolen away. But Neal could not get her hands on the ball after she slapped it away from DK. DK dove on top of it, forcing the tie basketball. TJC will keep it on their side of the court. Try to inbound. They finally do. Get it inside to Bennett. Bennett high up the glass. No good. Rebound is Isabello. She'll give TJC a fresh shot clock. They did not give her the rim. He's 8 on the shot clock. Bouncing around outside to DK. DK's got to put up an air shot. That will rim off. Up court to Blinn. Gets the rebound and a quick drive and a breakaway layup is up and good by Richardson. Blinn out to a 5-point lead. 56-51. Buccaneers. TJC now will. Kone loses the basketball on the way up and having to force the foul. As they would not let Kone take it to the hole uncontested. And foul is going to be called on Singleton. Unfortunately for Singleton, that is her fourth personal foul. So DK will sit down and Morgan will check in for her. Shalane Morgan, a 5'8 freshman out of Houston. And back at the free throw line to shoot free throws is Fonta Kone. And Kone makes good on her front end. First one will fall for Kone, back to a 4-point lead for Blinn. Kone sinks them both. For a young lady that has not been to the free throw line very often this season, 18 of 24 when the game started. She has been there a few times in this ballgame this afternoon. Penetrating for Blinn. Handing off Jones to Jackson. Throwing up an errant shot. Boy, Jackson just kind of chunked it up as best she could. Excuse me, Richardson. TJC will come down with it, coming down court. TJC, Bennett, over to Isabello. Isabello, short jump shot's up and good. Isabello with a 1-point game now for Blinn. Wide open, 3-pointer, and going down on what may have been a little bit of a dive was Winter Jones. Winter Jones gave that all she could with the limited amount of contact there and forcing a fourth personal foul on Fontecone. Oh, my. Winter Jones, who had a wide-open three, and Kone came flying by. And I know y'all, everybody's been watching plenty of basketball as Jones will miss the free throw, but when you are up in the air and you're shooting a shot and someone flies by you to the right side and you fall off to the left side, it is reason to laugh a little bit. Because if it doesn't prove you might be putting a little bit of extra effort into the flop thing. It is funny to watch. The officials will do it. But Winter Jones will make good on that foul and makes two of three free throws. 58-55, Blinn College. Working her way to the hole, can't get it to fall. But drawing the foul on the drive that time, Jefferson taking it hard to the rim. And will draw the foul. There has been a ton of whistles and physical play this afternoon. Second personal foul going to be called on Nala Richardson. And Jefferson setting at the free throw line right now. Alexandria Jefferson. And if I could see how many points she had on our scoreboard, I would let you know what's going on, but we cannot from our vantage point. High atop Wagstaff. 58-56, Jefferson hits the front end and the back end. It's as good as a bucket. 58-57, Blinn over the Apaches of TJC. Blinn cross midcourt to Thomas. Thomas handing off to Walton. Walton keeps it right side. Working her way inside and just pushing a defender back and drawing the charge. Johnson kept backing and backing and backing into Isabello. And on about the fourth bump, Isabello went down and will get Johnson. Draw the charge to Johnson, and she will foul out now with 7:29 to go in this ballgame. 1-point game for Blinn. Blinn Buccaneers. TJC going high under the glass and a foul called. But I tell you, this may end up being our longest basketball game of the entire tournament. There is very little action without a whistle this afternoon. So foul inside is going to be the first personal foul on Kincaid called. TJC will inbound to Welch. Welch to the left side, stays on the wing. Rotating it top of the key to Jefferson. Jefferson back, will dribble it around and trade places to the left side with Welch. Welch works it around to the right side. Kone will drive high off the glass and good. Kone with a great drive, up the baseline. Giving TJC a 59-58 lead. With 6:57 to go, teardrop, nice lay-in, and a great individual effort by Thomas to answer. Shania Thomas comes back with a bucket of her own to give them a lead change. Blinn by one now, 60-59. Inside pass, hard shot, and Morgan will force her way in. Gets the shot she may have wanted, but body contact will make her alter her shot. Taking it all the way to the rim and drawing the foul and going down hard, as everyone seems to do this afternoon. Foul's going to be called on Morgan.
Shane Morgan with her third foul.
So Shalane Morgan with her third personal foul.
21 at the line, Gianna Mathis.
Mathis will go to the line. She hobbled a bit when she went down. I think she banged.
Number five.
her funny bone on the ground. She, as you can see her rubbing corner of her elbow, or she may have got stung a bit when she went to the ground. It did not affect her shot or her follow through as she makes the free throw to put Blinn back up by two. ...61-59, dribbles down, shot is up, and it's good. 3-point lead for Blinn, the Buccaneers. And Apache's going back and forth here at Wagstaff. Jefferson with the basketball. Takes it right side, wrap around, no, it's gonna get stolen away by Blinn. Up court, it'll go to Jones. Jones taking it to the hole and will get fouled on the shot that goes over the backboard. And Jones will go hard into the standard. And the basket support. And will get up hobbling a bit as she may have hit it at an angle. And boy, that is the bad part about it. If you're going to go down with contact when you're going hard to the basket, you're absolutely taking a chance of crashing into something that's back there behind the basket. This is a college gym where you've got the supports and the backboards that you have to roll in. This is not a some of the high school gyms where they're just hanging from the ceiling. So there's a huge, large apparatus back there that's padded. Free throw goes in, first one and second one. 5-point lead for Blinn. As Jefferson will sit down, and coming in for Jefferson is Kiana Bennett. Bennett back on the floor for TJC. Isabilo, Kamora Jackson, Conate, and Welch on the floor for TJC Apaches. Almost losing it back to midcourt. Running it down is Jackson. Jackson will reset right side wing. 6:02 to go in this one. Inside pass to Isabilo. Outside to Kone. They have to run it down again. Trying to get a handle on the basketball. Welch trying to free up for a three. Kone's open for a three. Short, no good. And it'll go off the backside of the rim and just fly out of bounds off the rim. Turnover TJC on the errant shot. And Blinn will get the basketball back and a 5-point lead. 64-59 with 5:48 to go. Rotating it, top of the key. Now dribbling, forcing a shot up and drawing the foul on Isabilo. And that's going to be Kincaid on the drive. So Isabilo now has picked up her fourth personal foul.
22 on the line, DJ Kincaid.
So 1, 2, 3, 4, 10 different players for TJC have fouled out one time. Free throw is up and good. Well, the Buccaneers have made absolute magic out of their free throw shooting this afternoon. 20 of 24 in the first half. Free throw is up and good. So DJ Kincaid will knock down her free throw. Both of them, and the free throws are the difference in this ball game. 66-59, 7-point lead for Blinn with 5:30 to go. Kone trying to run the offense for TJC. Lillian Jackson gets the basketball back to Kone, and we're going to get a foul called. Blinn Buccaneer went to the ground, and the foul is going to be called on Thomas, and Thomas is absolutely does not know what's going on. And then she starts to giggle, so she might know what's going on. Janiyah Thomas, 5'4 freshman with her second personal foul, is going to put Kiana Bennett at the free throw line. And Bennett will stop the scoring drop for TJC for the moment. Picks up a free throw, and it's a 6-point ball game. Bennett, two hard dribbles. Second free throw is up and good. 5-point ball game with 5:21 to go. Apaches looking for a couple of stops, maybe a couple of turnovers or missed shots. They get a partial block by Kone, and there's one of them right there. Welch comes down with the basketball. Good dribbling skills down across half court. Up court it'll go back to Welch. They are not letting Welch open for three. Long three-pointer is popped down by Bennett. They left Keanu Bennett open on the right side wing, and TJC pulls to within two. 66-64. What a ball game. Blacks three-pointers up and no good, this time by Elizabeth Walton trying to answer. TJC gets down court quickly. Trying to down court pass, and it's intercepted. A block by Walton. Probably stopped an easy bucket for TJC, throwing up a wild shot on the drive. No one touching her. Down court quickly it'll go. TJC with an easy bucket and a lay-in, and we're tied at 66. 7 unanswered for TJC. And 6 is across the board. What a ball game this afternoon. Extra steps that time on the drive by Elizabeth Walton, and turnover. Blinn will go back to TJC. We got a media timeout in the fourth period. Oh my, 66 all. Blinn and TJC, 4 and 5 seed, finishing things up when we come back. NJCAA Regional Basketball Tournament continues from Wagstaff Gymnasium on the TJC Broadcast Network. Well, you don't like using the old adage, tale of two halves, but it's not there's been a lack of intensity in this basketball game, but back and forth we have gone. Blinn College and TJC, conference rivals for a long time, very well-respected programs from both benches, and battling it out, tied at 66. TJC basketball, and unfortunately getting caught in midair, Lillian Jackson with an up-and-down call and a travel. And Blinn and TJC trading bad turnovers there in consecutive possessions. Long three-point shot. Front side of the rim, no good. Rebound pulled down by Blinn. And getting the putback is Jasmine Jackson waiting under there all by herself. Great blockout job by Jackson. Puts Blinn back up by two. 68-66, 3:37 to go on the game clock. Somebody wants to play on Friday. Back and forth, Kone over to Welch. Welch down right side to Jackson. Jackson, inside will go, turnaround. Isabello with a tough shot to tie it up at 68. Turnaround Isabello in traffic. And that young lady's playing with four fouls also. Inside the circle, trying to stop the drive. No contact, Isabello with the rebound on the bad shot. Kone coming down court, pushing it hard. Down the right side, three-point shot, long, no good. Rebound, scrambled for. TJC will save it. Welch will pull it down. TJC basketball with 2:57 left. Isabello, short jump shot, no good. Gets her own rebound, misses again. Rebound Isabello on the miss, that time by Jackson. TJC with a third shot clock opportunity here. 2:42 to go. Apache women, top of the key, and errant pass as it'll go over the hands. And it was going to be Blinn basketball, but unfortunately, Neal ran after it, thinking it was off on them. It will bounce out of bounds. Neal will be standing out of bounds when she touches it. So TJC basketball, and it will reset to 20 seconds. And no, they will reset the shot clock, I think, to 4. It did not officially change possessions, so TJC will now inbound underneath their own basket with a 4-second shot clock. It's easy for me to say. Kone will inbound. She does so. Pull-up jump shot, 12 feet, no good, air ball. Thrown up by Jackson, and here off we go. Blinn coming back down. Top of the key, it'll go. They're going to try to slow it down a bit. Mathis will hand the basketball off to their point guard. And leading scorer, Janisha Neal. Neal to the right side, 2:12 to go, tied at 68. Neal trying to look down the baseline, gets blocked out of that. Top of the key to Singleton. Singleton around the back dribble, almost loses it. Now pull up, jump shot, 2 from the high blocks. Lob shot. And it will fall, 70-68 Blinn. A minute 49 to go. Inside the circle, long two-point shot, way off by Isabello. Blinn with the rebound. Here come the Buccaneers, crossing midcourt, slowing it down is Mathis. Mathis back and forth, looking to set it up. Holding the ball, a minute 30 to go. Jeff Jenkins is yelling, spread it out, spread it out. Three-point shot is good! Oh, my, what a pressure shot by Chelsea Singleton. Pounds the three. Back the other side of the court, trying for the short two-pointer. Lillian Jackson, no good. Rebound, pulled down. Isabella fights for it. She gets the basket and one. Oh, my.
Got the basket.
Chelsea Singleton hits the tray to put Blinn up by five, and then coming back on the other side, Isabella fights her way underneath the basket, gets the basket to cut it back to three, could cut it to two with this free throw. Man, the dramatics here in the fourth quarter with these two basketball teams. Isabello taking her time. Setting the stage, picks up her dribble. It's a two-point ball game. Free throw goes down, 73-71 Blinn. A minute 10 to go. Blinn Buccaneers across midcourt with Neal. Neal looking top of the key, rotating the basketball to the right side. Singleton with a cutter. Winter Jones will stay to the left side. Double teaming and throwing up a shot out of nowhere. And that's not the shot Singleton wanted, but she tossed it up in traffic without squaring even up to the basket. So TJC break right there as Kone gets it to the left side wing. TJC basketball, a chance to tie it. Top of the key to DK. Back outside to Welch. And Welch, when she puts her right foot back to plant it to jump off of it, steps out of bounds, turnover Apaches. Blinn basketball with 32 seconds to go. They are holding the ball, crossing midcourt with Neal. Neal and Welch. There is a 5-second differential, game clock to shot clock. Welch and Neal fighting for it. Welch will foul Neal finally. Wow, what a key turnover moments ago with Welch stepping out of bounds as she was rotating back to the middle of the court, back to the top of the key, and just got a foot out of bounds. The official was right on top of it. She will end up getting forced to foul with 17 seconds to go. Neal will make the first free throw. 74-71 Blinn. TJC will get the basketball back either down by three or four with 17 and a half to go. Neal squares up, dribble. Shot is up and good. It's a four-point lead. TJC wants a timeout.
Timeout.
And they will take a full one here. 75-71 Blinn, 17 and a half seconds to go when we return. NJCAA Women's Regional Championship Basketball continues at Wagstaff coming up next.
Coming back hopefully for session number four.
Out of the Trina Tillis Horde, full timeout. TJC will inbound. They get it in quickly to Bennett. Bennett over to Isabello. Isabello with the shot up, no good. Rebound, Blinn College. Ripped down by Winter Jones. Jones wanted to get away, try to stop the foul. Isabello is forced to foul her on the drive from one side of the court to the next, and that will be five for Isabello. And the clock will stop with 9.3 seconds to go after the miss by Isabello.
16
is almost a last-ditch effort there to give TJC an opportunity at a turnover and coming back for a second basket, but they will be forced to foul. And heading to the free throw line is Winter Jones. And Winter Jones tacks on an extra. It's a 5-point lead now for Blinn with 9.3 to go. Winter Jones stands in confidently, pops her second free throw, and timeout TJC.
Timeout.
As it is now a 6-point ball game. TJC wants a full timeout here as well. And oh, they'll tell him to stand up. It's got to be a 30. So a 30-second timeout for TJC and Jeff Jenkins and the Blinn Buccaneers with a two-possession basketball game, up six with 9.3 seconds to go. Number four seed is 9.5 seconds away from moving on to play on Friday in the semifinal round against Angelina. TJC will inbound in front of the scoreboard. Buzzer goes off about the time the official hands the ball to Kone.
All right, here we go.
And now we're set to go. Kone will inbound with 9.3 to go. Inbound. Turn around. They got to put up a shot. 3-point shot by Jefferson is off. No good. Rebound off of TJC. And no, a foul's going to be called. Oh, my. Well, a foul will be called on Janisha Neal. The ball went off the front side of the rim, and it came down and looked like it was going to go off of one of the legs and out of bounds. It ricocheted right out of bounds, but a foul called, and Bennett's going to go to the free throw line and hit a free throw here with 4.1 seconds to go. So it's a 5-point ball game. Missing the second free throw, scrambling for the basketball. It'll roll into the hands of TJC up to Welch. Welch has got to put up a shot. The clock will go to zeros, and that is it. The Blinn Buccaneers will take down TJC 77-72 is our final. As Blinn will move on to the semifinal round to take on Angelina at 3 o'clock on Friday afternoon. We will take a quick timeout, give you some totals when we come back. Blinn moves on, 77-72 win over TJC. Totals coming up next. Listening to NJCAA Regional Basketball Championship games at Wagstaff Gymnasium on the TJC Apache Broadcast Network.
And 11 for Winter Jones, also off the bench, almost all free throws. For the TJC Apache ladies, 16 points for Grace Esipilo, as I mentioned, 24 for Amari Welch off the bench, 12 off the bench, and 10 for Confacone. Apache ladies finish a very successful season, and the Lady Bucks will advance to the next round. The Lady Bucks from Blinn will advance to play Angelina College, and then the matchups this evening are Trinity Valley and Paris, and then Gilmore versus Manola as the nightcap. As far as the men's are concerned, tomorrow we'll start at 1 o'clock with the number one seed, the Navigators from Lee College in Baytown against the Paris Dragons. And then Blinn and Gilmore at 3, at 6 tomorrow in Manola, and then at 8, Angelina and Trinity Valley. Those will be your Thursday matchups. And then Friday we'll have another four games. We'll have the women's semifinal and the men's semifinal. That should be fun, the ladies at 1-3, and then at 6-8. And then we come back on Saturday at 4 for the women's championship and 7 for the men's championship. We're so happy that you chose to be a part of the Region 14 four season tournament here at the historic Wagstaff Gym at Timer Junior College.
Beckett Wagstaff Gymnasium giving you some totals for game two of our game, or day two of the regional championships. As TJC will fall, the host school will fall to Blinn. Number four taking down number five. 77-72 is our final. Looking at some numbers, and they were massive this afternoon for the Blinn College Lady Buccaneers. 20 points for Chelsea Singleton, leading all scorers this afternoon. She finished also with a couple of rebounds and two steals, but she did most of her damage in that first half. 8 of 15, 3 of 5 from the three-point line, and only 1 of 4 from the free throw line. But these numbers are crazy once we get to the totals. We'll give them to you here in a second. 17 points, 3 rebounds, and 5 assists for Janisha Neal, 17 and 3. She also had 5 assists on the afternoon. 10 points, the only other one in double figures. 10 points and a couple of rebounds for Winter Jones, who came back nicely in that second half, made a great steal, good defensive effort, and then hit the two free throws that pretty much put the ball game away late in this one for Blinn. Blinn College finished the game 33% from the field. They only hit 4 of 14 from three-point, but they did not need it because of their free throw numbers. 37 for 48, hitting 77% of their free throws for the game. 37 for 48. They were 20 for 24 in the first half. So a ton of free throws there. 20 for 28 for TJC on free throws. They were led by 3 players in double figures. 14 points, 17 rebounds for Gracie Zabilo. She finishes the night 8 offensive, 9 defensive rebounds, also with a steal and a couple of assists. 12 points, 5 assists, 7 rebounds for Amari Welch, who was also 3 of 6 from the 3-point line, 3 for 4 from the free throw line also. 10 points, 6 rebounds as well for Fanta Kone. She finished with 4 assists, 2 steals, and 2 blocks on the night. 8 points for Alexandria Jefferson. She finishes with 8 points, 2 rebounds, and a couple of assists. 8 points, 5 rebounds as well for Finishka Bertho, who fouled out with about 9 minutes to go in the ball game. We say so long to the host schools. Yesterday, TJC men dropped their game. TJC women will lose this game this afternoon. So they will be done for the tournament, both teams here locally, out in the first round. The Blinn Buccaneers will move on. Both men and women are playing in round 2, as we will see them both either tomorrow or Friday, as the women will move on to take on Angelina 3 o'clock on Friday afternoon. We will be taking a break. Session 2 will start in a little less than an hour. Manny Almanza will have both night games for you at 6 and 8 o'clock, as we're looking forward to Trinity Valley taking on Paris. That is the 2 seed taking on the 7 seed, and Panola at the 6 seed will be taking on Kilgore, number 3 seed, that coming up at 8 o'clock tonight. We say so long for now. Session 2 is coming up in less than 50 minutes as TJC falls to Blinn. The Buccaneers 77, TJC 72. We say so long for right now, as session number 2 is on the way in less than an hour on the TJC Apache Broadcast Network.